Absolutely.
And then there is all of this from Chris Christie, who, along with being a former Republican governor, is also a former federal prosecutor. And so Christie tells Chris Cuomo he is certain that the SDNY, the Southern District of New York, is building a case to indict Trump once he leaves office. Listen to this.
What they're doing, I'm confident, is building a case for two things. One, to go after those around the president who may have committed crimes. And two, to build a case if they have one. I don't think they have one at the moment, but if they're trying to build one against the president for when he leaves office. Statute of limitations on most of this stuff, my guess is, would not run.
Ellie Honig is a former U.S. attorney with SDNY and is a CNN legal analyst. And so do you agree with Governor Christie?
I agree in part, and I disagree in part with my former governor from New Jersey.
Okay, talk to me about agreeing.
I agree that Governor Christie has addressed the key question of where is the accountability going to come from? DOJ has this policy. We cannot indict a sitting president. People do not like that policy because what it does is it places the president a little bit above the law. So what can be done? What Governor Christie said, he can be indicted when he's out of office. People around him need to be investigated. If someone committed a crime with the president, it doesn't mean that person gets a free pass. Mm-hmm. And then it also, to me, underscores the importance of impeachment proceedings and the battle that we're going to see over the Mueller report. Because if you cannot indict, the only remaining remedy, accountability, is impeachment. So it's all the more important that Congress
sees the full
get that
Mueller
information.
Report.
So I agree on the notion of accountability. I respectfully disagree with the conjecture by Governor Christie that the Southern District does not have a case as of right now. Based only on what we know, and of course we don't know everything the Southern District knows, on the campaign finance violation, we have Michael Cohen's testimony. We have Alan Wesselberg, the CFO who was involved in this, who's got the immunity deal with the Southern District. We've got the tape where Michael Cohen's talking about this project with Donald Trump, and we have now a signed check. Governor Christie was an excellent, aggressive prosecutor. I think he would have charged that 100 times out of 100.
So what would this look like depending on if he loses or is in office for another six yeah. years? And what about the statute of limitations?
So that's the question. And Governor Christie talked about that,
yeah.
too. Generally speaking, you have to charge federal crimes within 5 years of when they occurred. That's what people mean by the statute of limitations. But there's this notion of tolling. It's the legal term, but it means stopping the clock. And statutes of limitations get told when something beyond the control of people happen. For example, if someone's a fugitive and takes off and you can't arrest them.
Or if someone is the president.
Or
of
if
the
someone
United
is
States.
In this, exactly right, has this unique role where DOJ policy says we won't indict that person. So I do agree with Governor Christie. It's likely that the statute of limitations would be paused.
Okay. Sean Hannity.
Yeah.
Interviewed the president last night. So let me play this clip. This is part of the interview.
I was kind of dragged in a little bit into the Michael Cohen issue. I interviewed him many times on radio and TV. He was never my attorney. He did apologize to me for his attorney saying that in court. But I can tell you personally, he said to me at least a dozen times that he made the decision on the payments and he didn't tell you.
Yeah.
Told me
yeah.
personally.
Well, he did.
Did Hannity open himself up to a subpoena?
He might well have. The first thing I see Sean Hannity doing there is trying to put a defense in Trump's mouth of it was all Michael, it was Michael acting alone.
Mm-hmm.
That's really hard to square with the tape of Michael Cohen discussing this with Donald Trump, but he's trying to offer that up to President Trump. Yeah, Sean Hannity might have bought himself a subpoena with that statement. He says, Michael told me it was just him acting alone. If I'm investigating, I want to know that. Maybe it's true. If it is true, it undermines Michael Cohen's testimony. It's important to know that. It could be helpful to the defense. It's what we call Brady information. You have an obligation as a prosecutor if you find information that's helpful to a defendant to turn that over. So mm-hmm. it's one thing for Sean Hannity to say that
on
into
television,
the cameras,
not under oath.
But
right?
It's a different thing when you're under oath and under penalty of perjury.
Totally, of course. Ellie Honig, you're the best.
Thanks, bro.
Thank you very much.